Welcome back to my YouTube channel. As you know, it's your boy Victor Kanti, and I'm here with the music critic himself.
Just text.
Okay. So today, what we are going to be doing, we are going to review the top 10 albums of the year 2020. Without further ado, let's roll into the video.
Made in Lagos was an extremely cohesive body of work. Originally, the first Nigerian album to debut in the US Spotify records in the last decade after King Sonia.
So, Ayo, as I like to call him, displays his laid-back philosophical nature. From the entrance in the intro to Reckless, people think it's mumble music. Them in that, do you listen to the sheer essence, the brilliance, the sophistication? Is exhilarating, is extravagant. It was extremely exceptional, top of the line.
Thank you. I'll give it an 8 out of 10.
Number 9 album of 2020 is Amare is the Angel You Don't Know. Amare is a Ghanaian American artist, for those of you who do not know. Alte by nature, feisty by definition. Her album featured likes of CK, Saudi, Odunsi, the top Alte people that you would consider. It has a certain je ne sais quoi. It was wow. That's all you can say. The Angel You Don't Know was extremely wow. It was just perfect. There was no inadequacy except for some few personal grievances.
Okay. If I'm to rate it out of 10, I'll give it an 8.35.
So guys, number 8 on the list, we have Shoot for the Stars, Aim for the Moon by Pop Smoke. And I want to hear.
What do you call that scene? You know where you open bottle of wine and then this thing come out? It a pop smoke.
Stars in for the moon. Pop smoke.
Yeah, it was executively produced by 50 Cent, who also featured on track 9. I can't remember track number, along with Roddy Ricch with 2 H's, cause Wahala forget 1 H. Then I feel the album, as a going away, passing on legacy project, was it wasn't the best, because Pop Smoke was going to be the one to bring US drill back, because UK likes of Stormzy, Heady One, and other UK guys were the forerunners of drill. Pop Smoke was doing it in the US, making it commercialized. Unfortunately, they don't pan. But summary, it was okay, could have been better, especially with the feature selection. I prefer the deluxe, maybe because of the bias that there was the Dan Burner Boy. But overall, I'll give it an 8.42.
Okay.
The Conspiracy by J Hoss.
So, to our music critic, what do you have to say about that album?
Let the essence flow. Okay, Big Conspiracy by J Hoss, long time Burner Boy collaborator, featured repeat violin. J Hoss featuring Coffee, also featured playing with Burner Boy, amongst some few other notable mentions. It features his charismatic self. Anything I do, you know I do. They lift people away from Matty Woman. The guy was talking about how he liked Nyash. Basically, say, give her the cucumber.
Excuse me, people, young people are watching this. Why are you trying to?
I'm not saying he's doing that. What am I doing?
Okay.
Big Conspiracy was
it was such a true truth telling album.
I'll give it an 8.63. What about you?
I would it's definitely up there. I'll give it an 8.7124. But if you approximate, if you just end for like 8.71, if you want to be crying, maybe like 9. Sorry, I had to.
Okay. It's going to be Love Goes by Sam Smith.
I feel like I'm stuttering because these songs are fire. Those, yeah. Okay, featuring my favorite track is Oasis featuring Burna Boy, because bias, always bias. The album at the same time still displayed Sam Smith's charismatic.
Number 5, we have Burna Boy's Boys as well. We have
Kehlani's It Was Good Until It Wasn't.
Yeah.
It shows her R&B fluidity as she messes around with different sounds to give an exceptionally sounding album. I swear it's like we do this all the time. I should be dreaming and I cannot lie. Give it a 9.05. Just a little bit above, or not up to 9.1.
Okay, I'm going to give that album a 9.2. 3. We have Ariana Grande with Positions.
Ariana Grande's Position was. Nothing, so true to me. I'm just hoping. Point of view, that's one of my favorite tracks from the album.
At number 2, we have Davido with A Better Time. Yeah, guys, so what do you think about that album? Talk now! I feel like we needed a better time this year because with everything that has happened this year. Time was an album that we all needed here.
A Better Time was a good collection of songs. It was like Ring Light at the end of the long tunnel. It was just there. To be honest, the songs were good, but not. They didn't flow well together as a body of work. It wasn't a better time. A good time still around it, but
well,
sure. Let's just
for me, that's a better time is number 2 on the chart. Okay, guys, number 1, we saved the best for the last. You know the vibe. You know the vibe. So, would you like to tell them what number 1 is?
The number 1 album for 2020.
Yeah. At number 1, we have, according to, not just me, according to the public, according to the real critic here, number 1 is
The Weeknd's After Hours album.
Like this hits, this track list of back-to-back hits.
People are surprised they didn't get a Grammy nomination.
I could not have chosen any other album to put as number 1. So guys, that's we've come to the end of this video. Let us know what you think about this video. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up, like, don't forget to subscribe and share this video. Use this opportunity to thank you all. This journey so far has been amazing, seeing everyone sharing my link and doing everything. I really do appreciate you guys, and I don't take you guys for granted. We hope to do better this year, 2021, and we just want to wish you all a very, very, very happy new year.